Hey everyone, welcome back to Adobe's Learn from the Pros tutorial series. My name is Boone. In this five-part tutorial series, I'm showing you how to create a cool map animation inside of Adobe After Effects. In the first episode, we talked about how to animate the path as well as some markers. In the second episode, we set everything up in 3D space. In the third episode, I showed you how to work with lights. In this fourth installment in the series, we're going to be animating our 3D camera as well as adding some depth of field, which is really fun. Okay, things are starting to get a little busy here in my project, a little system intensive. So I'm going to change my resolution down to 1/3 so that things are a little bit easier to work with. As I talked about before, I'm gonna harness the power of Draft 3D, and that's gonna get rid of those shadows temporarily, but it's gonna allow us to work in real time. So now I want to animate my camera. This isn't the best layout to do that. So I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna switch this to two views. On the right, I wanna have my active camera view. And then on the left, I'm gonna use this left view. So in the sample animation, you can see that our animation consists of this camera just flying over our map. And I want this to fly perfectly parallel with our map because our map is flat on the ground plane here. And we're just gonna move this straight across parallel. Now, if I grab the camera, we have a bit of a problem, and it has to do with our position here. Check out our Z. We wanna move this in Z space. However, if I grab this and I try to move it, it's simply moving it closer to our map or further away. And I don't want it to do that. I want it to fly perfectly parallel. So this has to do with the axis mode. So up here you can see it's currently set in local axis mode. However, I can switch it to world axis mode. So local axis mode is essentially relative to the layer. So here you can see the camera is facing this way because I changed the angle. Well, the local axis mode is going to reflect that change of rotation. If I want to show it in world mode, I simply click this way, and now it's relative to the world. And since I rotated my map perfectly at 90 degrees in relation to the world, it's now perfectly parallel to this layer in world mode. So now with this world mode axis selected, I can now move the position here and fly this perfectly over the map. And this is once again why I rigged it this way. Now I can grab the camera layer, click P for position, and I'm gonna add a keyframe here and just we're gonna select the starting position. So it's gonna start somewhere over here. I'll move this keyframe to the beginning and now I'll grab the position and we wanna end somewhere over here. And actually this is animating way too fast. So I'm gonna use the whole 15 seconds here. So we're gonna bring the keyframe to the end here, but I also need to go and grab that keyframe of my path that I animated before. And I'm gonna extend this out as well to maybe like 10 seconds. And naturally, I'll need to retime these map markers as well. I'll do that really quickly. I want to add a little bit more movement here, so I'm going to actually rotate the map ever so slightly. So I'm going to go over to the map layer here, and I'm going to hit R for rotation, and it'll bring up the orientation as well. Bring the playhead back to the beginning, and I've got this nice curve here, and I want to, you know, show just ever so subtle movement here. So if I animate this on the Z axis, it's going to allow me to get some movement here. So I'm going to go ahead and add a keyframe here. And then maybe I can have it spinning in this direction. And we'll just do a little bit of a change here. And we'll full screen this. And let me remind you, this is 1/3 resolution here. I'm looking at this in draft, but the animation's looking good. Once again, this is allowing me to edit in real time without my computer catching on fire and me having to throw it out the window or something. So if I full screen this, you can see everything is in sharp focus. Even on the corners here, we don't have much depth to it. So I want to have like a little focal plane here of shallow depth of field look. So what it'll look like is it will slowly fade out into a blur. As right now, it's like slowly fading out into like a darker area, which makes it look pretty cool and dynamic. I also want it slowly fading or transitioning into like more blur. And this is pretty simple to achieve. You just have to know what you're doing. So I'm going to double click on camera and then over here, make sure preview is selected. And I can just enable depth of field and then we're going to click OK. And now if I full screen this, everything's looking blurry, but it looks like we have some stuff in focus over here. So we need to move the focal plane or the focus distance. So the best way to do this is to switch back to two views. You're going to be able to see what's going on over here in left view. So if I double click camera again, I'm going to move my dialog box over here. Right now, this little checkbox here says lock to zoom. We want to deselect that. And now as I start to move the focus distance back, you're going to see something moving over here. This is your focal plane. So all I need to do now is move this back all the way so that it's intersecting right here with this layer. If you hold shift, it'll move faster. And I'm going to move this and look over here. Now we have some depth of field. It's starting to fade out a little bit here. And you can actually open this up and see the same parameters in the camera options over here. And just as with all cameras, if you bring down the f-stop, you know, if you bring this to a lower number, like say 2, it's going to make your depth of field more shallow. And that might be a little too much. And I'm gonna go ahead and pull that focal distance back even a little bit further. And here it, once again, here it is. Okay, so I pretty much have a finished animation here that looks great. In the next video, I'm gonna show you how to work with the Cinema 4D renderer and how we can achieve a totally different look with extruded shapes.